The South Coastal Hockey League.
Here come the Rangers trying to make something happen. Bobby Donahoe comes in, shot, score.
Oh, what a beautiful shot.
The South Shore's premier Masters Hockey League.
Scott Kelly coming up the near side, top of the circle. Goal!
Featuring the legends.
Mike Simon go off to the net. Simon, oh, what a save by Rick Kelly. Net Brinkman gets a break, goes to the net and scores. Jerry, come on, Phantom. Oh, we'll pick it up for the Canadiens. 5:20 to go. Harnish in front. Nice maneuver. Martin scored. 9 for second after tonight is Jim Stone. What a save. Across Antoni. The shot. Oh, Jeff Holstein.
Get ready for South Coastal Hockey. The game of the week. Two teams will battle it out for a chance to hold the South Coastal Cup. Game on.
It's South Coastal Hockey this week, the pregame show.
Let's join the South Coastal Hockey broadcast team and their guests for some insight into what's happening this week in the South Shore's Premier Masters Hockey League.
It's South Coastal this week, the pregame show.
Brought to you by Fallon Ambulance. We're driven to care.
Now let's join the South Coastal Hockey broadcast team.
Okay, guys, what's up?
Two of the better teams in the Classics Division square off tonight. The defending champion Blackhawks take on the high-flying Maple Leafs. With Bob Hanner, I'm Mark Deschamps, Director John Kapowski. As we get ready to bring you what should be a dandy of a game here in the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week, it's next on the South Coastal Network.
This broadcast of the South Coastal Hockey Game of the Week is brought to you in part by underwriting from Inkstone Printing, Commercial Printers of Brockton, Hospitality Mutual Insurance of Westboro, Fallon Ambulance, Rockland Athletic Supplies, Dr. John Parker of the Parker Chiropractic Offices in Hanover, Panera Bread, the Sunshine Pool Company of Pembroke, Frano & Frano, CPAs of Braintree,
the new Schick Hydro, for your skin,
That Bloomin' Place, Route 53, Pembroke, by Holly Tree Dental in Hanover, and by Stephen Lee Jewelers of Quincy Square.
Get ready for South Coastal Hockey, the game of the week.
No, and the funny thing is, the game of the night, the Saints get dealt their first loss in the Legends. The Crusaders behind Jim Callahan's 3 goals, 2 assists. 7-2 winners over the Saints. They just kept on charging the Saints net. In fact, they had a goal disallowed as the Leafs try to get the opportunity against Vinny Triani as they go in their road blues with the white numerals and trim as Dame Salvaggio takes it deep and couldn't get the shot off. Mike Maher steals the clear out pass. Oh, nice feed in front to Mike Bartley. Couldn't tip it in past Vinny Triani, who got the pad on. Vinny moves much quicker. He had a surgery a little while ago when he was in the Masters division, the old Masters division, when he was a member of the Vipers, and he was out for a while. But he moves much quicker now, and his defense also does a great job in supporting him. As Ryan just flips it through the neutral zone and ends up lumpy icing on the play. The Blackhawks, as Bob said, they're not scoring. But the funny thing is, no one can score on them.
Yeah, they don't have to. Yeah. One goal a game is, you know, 1.43 goals against. You don't need too many goals to win games with that kind of goals against.
8 games, they have let up 10. And they have only scored 16.
Yeah.
It's 2-1 games. I mean, they know. They're already playing playoff-type hockey. As Drew Fitzgerald in the offensive zone slides it across for Paul Lyons, one of the leading scorers. Second opportunity, and Lyons missed the net, as on the first, he had it blocked by the defense of the Leafs.
Yeah, I think Lyons is a little frustrated now. He saw that nothing but net there and just kind of flipped off the end of his stick because, boy, Andrew was down and out, and there's nobody between him and that net. And Paul's trying to figure out how he shot that puck wide.
Interesting. Sean Malloy arrived late. Dave Evans just went off. I don't know if Dave Evans was something with a skater injured. And we'll check on that. Leafs already without Jim Smith, one of their leading scorers. He's out with the flu. And he's also one of our producers for the South Coastal Hockey. And Jim just brought some equipment down and left the rink. That's how sick he was, and, you know, hopefully get better. As Lyons for Parrish trying to dig it through. Dave Evans had to get, apparently had equipment situation. And Dave Evans trying to get back around to the bench. He's getting a hard time. Denton tries to get it out of the zone. We can hear it down below us and just where we're broadcasting from in our booth. Dave Evans is watching, going, get me that whistle so I can get out there. Denton tries to clear it out, kept in by the Blackhawks, doing a good job. Tony Rota. Tony Rota's become a fiend out there and providing some great plays like that one, rolling around and firing it up and in on Andy Pelley, who grabs it and ties it up. And here comes Dave Evans. Yep. Just some equipment. Paul Mayer and Paul Lyons discussing things. That is going to be a great conversation because Paul Lyons can be very quick. And Paul Mayer, the long-time captain for the Leafs, has Mike Bartlett on the faceoff. As he and Norman Rassikot on the faceoff. Breakout pass for Studley goes by and rolls in. Was going to be icing. Vinny Triani has the plate and tie it up. And Studley just taps Vinny Triani's. One of those, yep, we're going to be seeing you a little more tonight, I hope.
Oh, it's funny, I talked about the Crusaders, their first loss tonight. Can you probably talk to Tommy Shaughnessy about that? He's probably going to say, you know what, it's probably a blessing in disguise to get that loss. I remember last year, 2 years ago, the Maple Leafs undefeated all season long.
Oh,
Dave Evans
was
saying, boy, I kind of wish we'd lose one now because to go the entire season and then the playoffs too, it's like something's bound to happen. Let's get this out of the way. So I think if you talk to Shaughnessy tonight after the game, he'd probably breathing maybe a sigh of relief to get it over with.
And it was funny. I'm trying to remember. I think it was the Rangers who got them. It was all of a sudden the Rangers just slid by him as Dave Converse will drop the puck. He and Billy Hinchey, the officials. We got the A-team officials out there. Two veteran officials running the show tonight. Mike Meyer carries it in, broken up as he got to the blue line. Jimmy Polito dumps it back. I always remember Artie Riccio saying he loves when he skated for the Blackhawks, playing with Jimmy Polito as a wing. He says you knew that you had somebody that you could rely on. Barcelo sends it ahead into the Leaf zone. Maher picks it up. Mike Maher looks around. Maher avoids one hit, gets around the pass, the boards, but it's kept in by Ryan. Flicks one in. Andy Pelley grabs it. Andy Pelley was going to stick it to the corner. Mike Maher says, nah, don't. Hold on to it. 8:45 to go, opening period. No score. Bruins beat the Red Wings earlier tonight in the Classics. Canadians beat the Red Wings 3-2, and the Bruins beat the, Canadians beat the Rangers 3-2. Bruins beat the Red Wings 3-2. I'll get it right sooner or later. There are only six teams in the Classics. I just couldn't read my own writing for a second. That scares me. Mayer for Denton. Breakout for Evans goes by him. Gauthier tries to get to the puck. Nut. Studley ends up with it off the deflection. Tries to roll it in. Vinny Triani making a nice save because he gets screened on the play by Tony Rota, who's trying to slow down the play. Blackhawks trying to come back. Humphreys, boy, he's been a major addition. He, Fitzgerald, and Rota been the big additions since Mulkern couldn't get the pass through to Humphreys, who was driving to the net. Humphreys rolls one in, and he just got it wide. Humphreys, when he played in the Masters division, he was more or less on the second line on the attack, but as far as this Blackhawks team, he has just been a force. Humphreys across. Fitzgerald put the stick on it and got deflected wide. As Rodner sees the puck go by him, Gauthier picks it up on the right wing side. Gauthier trying to get to the net around Rota. Drops it off for Evans and it got knocked away at the last moment. There's a good reason why the Blackhawks don't give up many goals. It was four white shirts that stopped Gauthier and Evans. They
yeah,
just
you're
had
not it, seeing yeah. One thing Vinny's not seen a lot this year is worried about rebounds. These guys are doing a great job of clearing them.
Salvaggio about as open a shot as the Blackhawks will let up right there. And Vinny Triani just knocked it down, tied it up, 7:23 to go in a scoreless first period.
I don't think Vinny even saw that puck.
Well, Vinny just looks like he's squaring up better. He looks a lot crisper. It's the best I've seen Vinny look. Parsons slides it across. Salvaggio shot. Nice stop by Vinny Triani. I mean, Vinny just still didn't give much for Salvaggio to shoot at.
Well, he's a big guy. I mean, he takes up a lot of space, and he can move very, like you said, since the operation, he's moving tremendously.
For a shoulder, I believe it was, remember, it was shoulder. It was like, as Parrish tries to squeeze it out, Parsons knocks it down. It's kept in as now the Blackhawks get control. You figure the Blackhawks would score more. Lyons, Dunn, Fitzgerald, and so forth. Than not. And as Pelly grabs it, ties it up. A few more whistles than I think you would have anticipated in the first little over 6 minutes played.
And the Maple Leafs still used to run away with this league, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Scoring-wise, and they're struggling offensively.
And then also just struggling right there is Hank Moskett just flicked one in from the blue line that beat Andy Pelly 1-0. It was just a
Yeah, I think Andy was
shot.
A little screened on that shot. Just came out. He saw that. Obviously, he knew it was coming from the point, but I think just got in the way of one of his defensemen's leg there, and all of a sudden, Andy realized he couldn't reach that far post. It was a nice shot. Picked that far corner.
The Blackhawks, the one thing you don't want to do as far as things go, John Dunn, who won the faceoff, gets the assist. But the one thing you don't want to do is spot them the lead. Not the way they're doing things right now. Barcelo. And the funny thing is, the Blackhawks, as far as this team goes in the South Coastal Hockey League, the last winning record, regular season winning record, was the fall of 2001. They had guys named Kelly and Goal, Riccio, as a forward.
Yep.
And they had a winning record, and they won a title. They haven't won. They haven't had a winning season. They had about 500 seasons. But the title that they won was their first since the fall of 2001. And they just, it's like they're feeding off that confidence. They look more confident on the ice. I always go back to something Drew Fitzgerald said a year ago. He said, it's like we had a meeting, we discussed, you know, hey, we got to play, you know, with a deeper forecheck, and we got to make things happen. And they've done it.
Yeah, they certainly have.
Denton.
Flexana. They've always got a full bench, too, which helps. You know, they're all having fun. They all want to come to the rink and play. Everybody's getting a lot of playing time. So, you know. Positive things just keep happening. They're going to continue doing what they're doing.
Well, you remember you won a few titles with the Grizzlies, and it was like you win the title, you roll, and you know, it becomes contagious. Marr tries to slide it through, can't. Ravner knocks it away, trying to get it ahead for Tim Fallon. Quietly, Tim Fallon, just the captain of the Black. He's got to be enjoying this.
Yeah,
I mean, his life is easier now. Jack Carrig. Tries to go through. Carrig can't. Carrig was broke up. There are two white shirts right in front of one blue shirt trying to get to the net. And they get good spacing in front of each, beside each other. So it's like nobody's colliding where somebody could just slide and sneak through. You know, one person on one side, one person on the other, and then all of a sudden the other person can break out and help out. Fallon comes up. Squeezes it through for Humphreys, lost it to Marr. Marr clears it out. Blackhawks change up as it was brought in offsides. Humphreys never cleared out as Hank Moskett.
Yeah, I think Moskett realized Humphreys was that deep in the zone. Just came in with his head down, barreling across that blue, and thought he had a nice opportunity.
Hank Moskett's second goal of this fall season has got the Blackhawks on top. 1-2.
Humphreys is probably, 20 feet inside the zone when he crossed the blue line. So.
Well, he's. Oh, Blackhawks get called for too many men. I didn't see that one. First power play. Saw the offsides. I just didn't see the call afterwards. As Moskett tries to clear it out. Dave Denton keeping it in at the blue line across for Paul Mayer. Mayer tries to line one up. Deflected right back to Denton. Denton is a pretty good guy you want to have at the point if you're the Leafs. Mayer. Mayer's a former forward in this league, playing defense, and he's done a solid job in defense. Gauthier tries to get it to the middle, broken up in the play. Gauthier, Studley, Evans, the line out there for the Maple Leafs as they control. They just can't get through the box of the Blackhawks.
I was just
going to
say, real impressively, the way that the Hawks are playing this penalty to perfection. Just, you said it right, the box. Oh. That's all they're doing, just sliding back and forth, not giving them any opportunities up front.
And there's an opportunity. Evans can't put it in because it got blocked. And then Triani blocked the shot by Studley. The first shot was blocked by the defense. The second shot, wasn't hitting, had much steam on it. Mayer from the blue line, deflected wide by Studley. Gauthier gets the puck. Back out to Denton, 25 seconds left. The shot by Denton goes wide. Tony Rota picks it up and clears it out. Even the shots don't have steam because they get knocked out. Or they're really just hurried. Mayer, 6 seconds left. The Leafs move the puck, just couldn't do anything with it as it's all even up. 2:51 to go, first period. Ryan tries to take it free. Harrington comes up with it, slides it across. Barcelo tries to clear it out. Jack Parsons taps it back towards the corner. Barcelo gets it out to Dunn at center ice. Dunn couldn't control it. Marr picks it up. Marr ahead for Harrington. Harrington, nice move at the blue line to get around Ryan. Harrington slides it across. Salvaggio shot right into Vinny Triani. And Vinny just sat there, played it, went side to side, and had the corner covered.
Actually, no shots on that power play for the Maple Leafs, although they did get a couple that were great chances, but like you said, the defenseman just got in the way and blocked them, steered them aside.
Made it easy. They're making it easy for Penny. Of the shots that the Leafs have had, this, how much would you say is a dangerous one in this? I can't remember one real dangerous one. Parrish knocks down the clear out for Lions. Lions might have had the best opportunity in the first period. Stolen, done shot, Pell, kick save, Pelly. Andy looked good on that one. One thing I'm always convinced with Andy, he needs that good start. Get a couple of shots, it's his icing on the play. I'm always convinced that Andy needs the quick start. And then he just builds momentum. The abominable snowman who builds those lovely snow castles in the net.
And that's why he needs a good start. He hasn't had a chance to build those this early in the game. So he's got
his intimidation.
Get those jersey barriers up and running.
Right.
Takes at least a period.
Barcelo shot from the blue line, knocked down by Pelly. Told me the last time when we had him on the game of the week, right, on the jersey barriers, he told me those jersey barriers that he had built in that particular game against the Rangers were for one reason. He wanted to keep his beer cold. Sean Malloy comes in, shoots it wide of the net, and Sean just tried to go near side and just shot it wide. Polito starts back. That was a great line. Andy was there. I had a great talk with Andy in the next rink, and he was laughing about it. Andy said, I still can't be. You know, why'd you pick me a game of the week? My teammates didn't carry me. We still say Andy looks one that goes wide by Jimmy Polito. Andy's still the odds-on favorite as far as the goalies go. If there's a goalie to get the first goal in this league, it is Andy.
Yeah, you know it's going to happen eventually. You think it's going to be him.
Yeah, he's just...
Is he certainly not bashful?
No. Fallon shoots it wide. The only other one was Al Spicer, and Al Spicer got hurt and just, you know, unfortunately, as the puck gets shot up into the bench with 34.6 seconds left. Spicer was the other one, I always thought.
Yeah, you could always see these guys, you know, playing pucks outside the face-off circle, near the blue line, just, you know.
The least person, I got to say, is, you know, a guy named Kelly. You know that? I don't see Kelly going for it. I see Barry Kaiser before Rick Kelly going for that, shooting it down in a late game. Then again, Rick is not out there at the end of those games. He and Barry alternate. Their game with the Toros is going on as we speak. Marr flipping it down to the corner. Evans trying to get it out in front. Gauthier will have to come around with it. Nice feed. Studley just took his eyes off of it. Humphreys clears it out. As now the Hawks will try to one more rush up the ice, will not get it. One period in the books. The only goal belonged to Hank Mosca of the Blackhawks after one. Blackhawks 1, Leafs nothing on the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week.
Back here at Hallmark Arena after one period of play, the Maple Leafs and the Blackhawks. Early shots on goal results. Blackhawks out shooting the Maple Leafs 9-7. Maple Leafs, you know, probably had a few more chances to get shots on net, but the Blackhawks defenseman's doing a great job of steering pucks away and blocking shots. But on the strength of an early period goal by the Blackhawks, they're leading this game right now, 1-0.
Studley.
Oh, no, it's right Jeff on Gauthier. The goal line. Yep.
Jeff Gauthier's trying. Jeff Gauthier, two for show. No, no. Studley shot it. It was in the Vinny Triani's pads right in front of where we broadcast from. Vinny had it in the pads. It was not even close. And Jeff Gauthier tried. He tried. Studley again. Triani just snaps it out of the air and ties it up in the first 21 seconds. The Leafs nearly answering the Hank Mosca goal that was scored in the first period by the Blackhawks. Rota can't get to the puck. Gauthier has it. You know, Leafs are suddenly trying to get something going. Fitzgerald breakout pass finds Mulkern coming up the right side. Mulkern has trouble and has to come back around, pick up the puck to the middle. Marr steals it, and here come the Leafs as Dave Evans trying to wheel his way up the ice. Some nice moves. Dave Evans putting on a clinic. Dave Evans going deep. Tries to slide it in front. He did everything, but he just had too many white shirts to get around. It just seemed like for each white shirt he beat, another one would come into the play, and then that one he beat would get back and prevent the pass. Denton near side. Denton looking. Denton's pass knocked down Ryan and broken up right back to Denton. Denton's pass up the ice. Rothner steals it. Off for Lyons, off his stick. Mayer picks it up. Mayer just bounces it off the boards. Pass Parrish, now pass Mosca. As it's picked up by Hank, he will take it back deep in his own zone and start up the ice with Rovner. Lyons up the near side. Here comes the Dunn. Snaps it off. Nice save. Andy Pelly with a pad. As Dunn had a good angle on that shot. Dunn again for Lyons. Tapped on. Save Pelly. Andy made a nice stop. Paul Lyons deflected it. It looked like it was heading to the far corner. Salvaggio, he has to wait for Ryan to clear to the zone and has to curl around a couple of times. Gets it to Harrington. Harrington's pass knocked down by Mosca. And now flip back in. Salvaggio has to clear out as Barcelo picks it up. This shift has been frustrating if you're the Maple Leafs because you have a chance to get in the offensive zone, but you get your pass knocked down at the blue line or deflected. As Triani will just watch the puck go for an icing.
Long icing call.
9:32 to go, middle period. We're tied at one next week. Stingers and Toros. Toros going on right now against the Sharks. That one's practically over. We'll get the result because Rick Kelly will come clean himself up because of the Schick Hydro postgame show. We hope.
We certainly do.
Yes, Rick has been handling that. He's become the star.
We've just got to come up with a player of the game for him before he shows up.
Right now, you can almost say the entire Blackhawk defense. Polito carries it in, shoots it, blocked. It's been a tough 1-0 game. Leafs looked like they were going to tie it, but Vinny Triani comes up with a couple of big stops. As the Leafs dump it in to the lock zone. Carrick tries to go after it with Ryan, and now comes free to Malloy. Malloy tried to tap it on net, ends up getting it back out to the blue line. Marr shot, blocked, loose puck, Bartlett, nice save, Triani with the pad. Bartlett get it at point blank range, and Vinny Triani just got the pad down, and Polito starts back. On the left it goes, Tim Fallon, slowed down by Malloy. Malloy ends up stealing the puck. Sean Malloy clears it out, and Kevin Ryan picks it up. Kevin Ryan looks, rolls it back in, as now Marr will grab it. Leafs trying to get out of their own zone. Bartlett stumbles but gets it ahead to Malloy on the left. Malloy gets cut off by Tony Rota. Carrick run into the boards by Rovner. Penalty on Rovner. Yeah, Dave in our no-check league just...
Well, Rota's actually quasi-checking the blue line right before that. I think kind of got the rep in the position of, okay, two in a row, I've got to call one of these. Because that first play at the blue line by Rota could have actually been called a check. And it was 3 feet in front of the referee as well. So I think the second time it happened, he was like, okay, somebody's going in here.
The old clutching, robbing her for checking and a no check flick. But, you know, the old thing, you know, we'll get what we can and, you know, see what we can slide right away with. And Humphries and Gauthier on the faceoff. Gauthier draws it back. However, he draws it back past Dave Denton. Studley will pick it up. Leafs last power play. Just got pushed around the perimeter. That's a great pass. Gauthier to the net. Triani just said, you know, you're going to have to just bore it through me. Because he just had the whole near side well covered. Gauthier. Rota ties him up. Gauthier kicks it free past Dave Evans because Barcelo helped poke it past Dave Evans. Cleared out. Mayer knocks it down away from Humphries. Mayer rolls it back in. Tony Rota will get it and scale it just past on Studley's face cage. Bouncing puck. Evans comes back. Evans lost it, but lost it right to Studley. Back for Evans. Evans get pushed away at the last moment by Barcelo and down below us. Studley ended up slipping.
That was just a quiet, great defensive play by Barcelo, lifting Dave Evans' stick. It was a beautiful 3-on-2 developing there. Evans went to the net just like he should have, and if Barcelo hadn't picked up his stick there, Evans was in alone.
Now the Hawks have done a great job in killing penalties. The first one they killed very nicely. They've only allowed one shot here in the second one. Gauthier slowed down by Tony Rota. And Gauthier goes to give it back out at the blue line. Nobody at home. And we're all even up. 5-on-5, 6, 38 to go here in the middle period. 1-0. Blackhawks and a Hank Mosca goal. As the Hawks right now just 4 points ahead of, 5 points ahead of both the Canadiens and the Bruins as we speak. And the Hawks trying to change that and get it back up to 7 points when they, that's what they had the lead by coming into tonight. Salvaggio knocked out in front, comes out. Harrington picks it up at the top of the circle. Triani just puts the glove out, grabs it. Tony Rota says, nice job. Tony Rota knows a little bit about glove work because he's also an assistant softball coach at Carver. Longtime assistant to Chuck Green. 6:03 to go here in the middle period, 1-0. Blackhawks, Barcelo gets the faceoff from Dunn. Sent around the boards for Parrish. Parrish trying to come out. Denton trying to slow him down. As on the second try, Parrish does get it out, but it's picked up by Salvaggio at center ice. Salvaggio turns around, finds Harrington. Harrington chips it ahead. Kevin Ryan knocks it back out. As now chipped back in. Ryan grabs it, clears it out. Center ice, Lions will corral it. Lions slowed down on the play by Marr as the loose puck picked up by Denton. Denton looks to the left, finds Jack Carrig. Carrig just hit a bouncing puck to try to slow down. Kevin Ryan knocks it away from Carrig into the Maple Leaf bench. Tonight in the Classic so far, Bruins in a 3-2 win over the Red Wings in a shootout. The Bruins with that win, getting 2 goals from Mike Martin, and the Canadiens beat the Rangers 3-2. Big story tonight, and the Legends Saints get clobbered and suffer their first loss at the hands of the Crusaders, who are steadily coming on, beating the Sharks and the Saints in back-to-back weeks. I was looking at Shoot the Puck and
quietly becoming a force in that division, Mark, you know, because it used
quietly
to be, you know.
It's all defending champs.
Yep.
Barcelo couldn't get it. Now we'll dump to the corner by Parsons for Bartlett. I was going to say on shootthepuck.com, one of the great lines was put down that they, earlier in the week, that Steve O'Meara was congratulated because the last week the Crusaders had to kill off 8 penalties. That Steve O'Meara is practicing in his driveway of killing off penalties paying up.
I
thought was the best line.
I couldn't believe when Rick came out, you know, came in after the game last week and told us that the Sharks had 8 penalties.
Yeah, Crusaders, 8 penalties. Those are mean Crusaders. Marr picks it up. You know, Tony, I usually kid about this the Stingers and with Tony Shaw as Malloy picks it up, tries to get it towards the net, but Carrick fires it. Petriani the save. Nice one off the chest. And Vinny knocked out. But I was laughing and saying that always. And then Rick forwarded me in an email. Sean Malloy is lucky. I don't know. He didn't get that lucky. He's going to get called
for a trip.
Yeah,
they're going to call him for a trip on that.
Jack Parson.
I thought he got away with it, too.
Yeah, I thought he did, too. Hawks will go on their first power play right now. Sean Malloy for a trip with 3:41 to go in the middle period. 1-0. Blackhawks on a Hank Muska goal. I was going to say, Rick forwarded me an email. Rick Kelly forwarded me an email that Tony Shaw liked the way that we keep on saying once at times with the Stingers in their devilish behavior, the goons. Yeah, Tony Shaw liked it. He's there. He wanted to compliment us. He still watches the broadcast. The Hall of Famer now down in Florida. We now have our Tony Shaw reference for tonight. I snuck it in. Fitzgerald shot. Nice save by Andy Pelly. What a save. Drew Fitzgerald got a bouncing puck and snapped it off, and that thing was had a trickling effect. That how Andy Pelly grabbed it out of the air, I don't know. Humphreys, Fitzgerald again, the shot. Andy again comes up with that. I love that kick
that
save
was,
by
yeah.
Andy.
That almost looked like one up a toe of his skate.
Third time for him. And he, that time Andy missed. But I love the way Andy does the kick save. You know that?
That is a showcase move right there.
It is a showcase move. Dump back in. Denton picks it up. 57 seconds left on the Malloy penalty as Mayor for Gauthier. And Jeff Gauthier will try to win the battle. The blue line does. Coming in. 2-1-1. Gauthier starts. Studley taps it in. Don Studley, shorthanded goal, and the Leafs have tied it with 2:55 to go here in the middle period. What a play by Gauthier.
Oh, beautiful pass. Actually, you know, defenseman made a risky move with the blue line. It paid off for the Maple Leafs, and I'll tell you, Studley's kind of thanking the stars on it because he knows that he fanned on that shot going to that pass, and still got just enough of it to put it in that short side. But he certainly wanted a bigger piece of that puck than he got.
Well, Don Studley gets his second goal, and it's a shorthanded one. And Palmeiro also gets an assist. Geez, the Leafs get two power plays, don't do much as Pelly knocks one away.
That was a shorthanded goal.
Yeah, it was a shorthanded goal. They do better shorthanded than they do on the power play. The Blackhawks might decline the power play from now on. Drew Fitzgerald got a couple great shots, but other than that, still 17 seconds left. I can see the Leafs now. Call timeout. Okay, Sean Malloy, take another tripping penalty. We play better this way. 4-on-5, we play better. Just kidding. All even up as Malloy heads off and Salvaggio heads on to join his line as Ravner picks it up. But Jeff Gauthier showed why he's still one of the best forwards in the Classics. That was a great move to the blue line. Oh, Salvaggio. John Dunn did a nice job. He didn't draw the penalty. Got enough of Salvaggio and got the puck away from him. Because Salvaggio was going to walk in. 1:42 to go, middle period. Tied at one. Parrish clears it out. Rolls it all the way down. Andy Pelly's going to watch
it's
it.
Gonna get there. No, he knows. Oh, they did call it.
They did call it. Andy, do you see the jersey barriers that Andy started building? He's got them built. Toros beat the Sharks 2-1. I looked down at tonight's games on our other board down the stairs. Toros beat the Sharks 2-1. Sharks stumbling lately.
Another losing streak in the making.
Another losing streak.
Two in a row for the Sharks.
Whoa.
Actually, it helped them tonight, though, if the Saints lost as well. So,
well, Saints look like they're going to be top seed, unless something crazy happens. If there was going to be an opportunity for the Sharks to come back, would have been tonight. He has the breakout pass past Harrington. And a whistle up. Cole goes off the moorings, and also a little cleaning up in aisle 5. Because a stick. knocked away from one of the Blackhawks, being Norm Rassikot, who gets
sick. Andy's going to really embarrass them when they up there. She take a shovel out of the Zamboni room when the mooring gets knocked off, and that they can't find the magnet because of the barrier around it.
I'm waiting for that one. I'm waiting for that. You know, the thing is, what I love, now Billy Hinchey and Dave Converse let the jersey barriers be built, and they enjoy it as Harrington sees the pass go behind him, but it just, and as he was going to the net by himself. But you know what's amazing? Some of these other guys just push the barriers away as Triani knocks down.
I used to do that when I played. I used to always know it. Second period, so I start looking. If we're playing Andy, it's...
Oh, what a feed! Front by Sean Malloy to Mike Bartlett! And the Leafs take the
lead.
Another
doorstep goal. Another great pass from behind the net. Vinny didn't have a chance on that.
Two goals, just 2:07.
Very opportunistic right now. Two goals in the span of 5 minutes, and they're back on top of this game.
2 minutes and 7 seconds,
yeah.
Officially. And look at here, folks. Look at here. Well, I'll tell you, this should be another assist. Sean Malloy was the one who made the pass from behind the net. Dave Evans, I don't think, was on the... Dave Evans was not on the ice. They gave Evans an assist, but Dave Evans was not on the ice as the puck gets knocked up in the ceiling. 2-1 Leafs. No matter what, it's still Mike Bartlett's goal. As Bartlett gets his third goal of the season. This could be a big one if the Leafs can build off of this one. Rovner shoots deflected over the net, and 4 seconds left. As Ryan will try one last time as it gets knocked down. Blackhawks look like they were in cruise control as far as this one, but the Leafs had something to say about it. Shorthanded goal scored by the Leafs on Studley, and Mike Bartlett adds a goal. And the Leafs in the final 2:38 of the second period go from 1-0 down to 2-1 ahead. We head to the third. Leafs by 1 here in the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week.
Back here, Al Marcarina, after 2 periods of play, Mark, the shots on goal. The Maple Leafs coming out strong in that second period, out shooting the Hawks 9-5. 2 period total, 16 for the Maple Leafs, 14 for the Blackhawks. And the strength of 2 second period goals, the Maple Leafs are now leading this game 2-1.
It was goals by a shorthanded one by Don Studley, and then Mike Bartlett with 38 seconds to go in the middle period gave the Leafs the lead. Sean Malloy made a nice pass to him, and Malloy right now, in fact, Sean Malloy, in a sense, has been at the focal point.
Yeah, he's been everywhere.
Yeah, he's been everywhere. Yeah, he was his penalty that the Leafs scored on for the shorthanded goal, and he set up that last goal, and he makes a nice move right there. Bartlett chips it ahead. Correa trying to get it on net. Boy, the Maple Leafs are all of a sudden just picking it up. Malloy tries to ram it through. Ryan prevented him, and Striani got a piece of it. I don't know, John. Do we send an email to Jim Smith saying the Leafs may not need you? I know. I mean, they're playing very well. It turned this game around. And it's like 2-1. Boy, I wonder if he is. Jim, if you are, I hope you're feeling better. As Andy Pelly grabs the Lions shot out of the air. Well, if he is, I mean, you know, Jim, we're just picking on you because we have nothing else to do in this 2-1 game. Your team is playing very, very well. Yeah, without you. Jim, our ace producer, helping us put this together here on our South Coastal Network. Coming out, Tony Rota shot. Nice save, Pelly. Woo! And Mayer and Rota are going to, I think, go to the box. I think you got both. Rota at least is going to the box. He didn't like the fact that Mayer chopped at him. Yeah, Mayer Now, Rota's got a point. Mayer chopped at him.
Yeah, I don't know if he's going to send the Leaf off or not, because the Leafs actually cleared that puck, and he didn't blow the whistle then, so we'll see what happens. But
yeah,
I think only the Blackhawks going in.
Tony Rota goes off. Yeah. Mayer got away with one.
He just went and apologized to him, too.
Yeah, roughing on Rota, and I think Mayer kind of knew he got away with
one. Yeah, he just went up the road on the block and said, I should be joining you, sorry.
Lions tries to come out. Leafs and two power plays have had one shot. They were better on, as far as shorthanded goes, they got their first goal that way. Marr back, looks left, gives to Parsons. I mean, Paul Mayer was just trying to slow down the play, and Mayer got a little too aggressive. Tony Rota didn't like it, and it was the way it was done, and you couldn't blame him. He got chopped at. Across the hands, and you know, Mayer knew it. Salvaggio fanned on the shot. He had a good opportunity. Dunn breaks out of his zone. You got to remember, too, and do have a shootout if we have a tie at the end of regulation, and Andy Pelley's trying to make sure that won't happen off that Tim Fallon shot. Andy had the near side well covered and ties it up with 9:19 to go in regulation. 2-1 Leafs. As next week, Stingers and Toros, the Toronto theme next week. Toros winning tonight over the Sharks, 2-1. Stingers playing that West Coast game. As Malloy and Craig trying to work it up the ice for a 2-on-1 in this power play that has 30 seconds left. Do we get our, obligation of one harsh shot with it's a late game? It's AARP game as far as that West Coast game goes for the Legends. Do we get it in there? All right, I got it in there. Used to be.
You can tell by the attendance, actually. The 9:40, if it's a Legends game at 9:40, you only got about half a bench.
That's it. The other half's asleep.
Yeah.
It is past the bedtime. They're home with the cocoa and the cookies. Or milk and cookies, whichever, their preference. It is, it was kind of crazy last night, with the snow. It was funny to see cars with snow on it today. And this is October.
Yeah, Polito, I saw it on the news. It was amazing how many, you don't realize how much snow they got, northwest of here, but. A bunch of school closings tomorrow, all over the state, It's not even Halloween yet, and the guys aren't having school tomorrow.
Can you see that, tomorrow? Hey, early trick-or-treating,
I'll say.
8:15 left, 2-1. But it was funny. It was like you looked at some of those East Coast football games on the television, all those highlights. Mm. It was unbelievable to look at some of those. Was it Rutgers game? It looked like it was like more, it was a lot of snow. You couldn't even see it.
Oh, there we go.
Another Leaf power play. Blackhawks have been a little frustrating. Yeah, fourth, two penalties here in this third period. 8:02 left, 2-1 Leafs. And surprisingly, Brian Barcelo.
Yeah, I was going to say, it looked like he was trying to sneak off and get onto the bench, but that wasn't going to happen.
I was going to say surprisingly Brian Barcelo, but I can't say that anymore because Brian Barcelo just got his seventh penalty. Seventh penalty for Brian Barcelo. That's kind of surprising. Evans flips it back in. But the Leafs got now three power plays, one shot, looking for their second shot on the power play. Meyer tried to give it to him. Broken up. Gauthier gives him that second shot from the circle with Robner draped on him. And a nice save by Vinny Triani. Well, the Blackhawks want to come back. One thing you don't want to do is get penalties. It's as simple as that. I mean, the Blackhawks are not exactly the type of team that can.
No, they're not lighting up. Yeah. They're not lighting up on the offensive side of the ledger so far this year. So.
Well, Humphreys tried to change that and tried to make us look bad. Bruce went to the net and got a good shot off. Then
tried
Andy
to make
Pelley.
You look bad. You were.
Yeah, I was my fault. Well, last week I kept getting those.
Oh
right.
Yeah, you were on fire.
I was
last
on fire
week.
Last week. Yeah, that's it. That's
every time
it.
You mentioned somebody's name, they did exactly what you said they were going to do.
It's over. The streak's over. I came back down to earth. Crashed. Man, harsh. I thought with the Blackhawks, you know, the defending champs, we've been pushing them. You know, it's nice to see him on the air. Mayer getting tied up by Dunn. 24 seconds left. This Leaf power play. Leafs 2-1 lead. Two goals in the last 2:38 of the last 2:55 of the second period, I should say. Second goal was with 38 seconds left. Mayer has his puck go off his stick. 3 seconds left. Maybe this is where Jim Smith is. Jim, if you're watching us at home, guess what? You need it on the power play. You definitely need it on the power play. Four power plays and only 2 shots for the Leafs. Blackhawks. Parrish. Boy, Tony Rota. Tony Rota is being frustrated. Tony Rota and Chris Harrington are talking about things. And Billy Hinchey comes over and says, Tony, come on. Enough is enough. I wonder if both we get both going to the bench.
Well, I know he had Rota first, so I'm going to grab Harrington now or not. Yeah, he is.
Blackhawks won the first game between these two, 3-1, and both go off, Harrington and Rota.
37 rough, 14 rough.
Tony Rota, second roughing penalty of the game, and one more for Tony Rota tonight. And Tony Rota gets to be part of the broadcast team. He can, you know, he can watch it from upstairs. Oh, the funny thing is, with all the Blackhawks, Blackhawks now have 35 penalties on the season. That's including the 5 tonight. 35 penalties for the Blackhawks.
Oh, but any evidence by the way the other team plays in the power plays, maybe that's a Blackhawks formula.
Oh, we got maybe the 36th penalty coming up. Norm Rascott says, me? Rascott was battling with Jack Parsons behind the net, and then they're going to say a slash on Norm Rascott.
Another man advantage for the Maple Leafs now.
Yeah, number five power play. 2 shots on four power plays, and let's see. It doesn't matter what level. You're playing with fire if the Maple Leafs. You're going to get burnt sooner or later. And in a 2-1 game, you're down. Boy, this is not, you're asking for it right now. Killing your line. It's as far as getting them, you know, getting them working together in this game. Killing every which way, you know, you can. The rhythm of your team is just getting destroyed. It's Mosca trying to get it around the boards. Hank Mosca got the Hawks on top, and since then it has been all Leafs as Triani knocks down the shot. Third shot in all the power plays as far as this one goes. Bartlett tries to squeeze it through. Can't. Back out to the blue line. Sean Malloy's shot gets deflected to the near side corner. 50 seconds left on the power play. Mara back out for Parsons. Parsons looks. Shot. He took a little too long. Blackhawks trying to clear it out. They can't get control. Mara gets it for the Leafs. Sends it around the boards. Jimmy Polito tries to get it. And does get it to Tim Fallon. Jack Parsons and the Leafs roll it in, and Vinny Triani nearly got handcuffed.
Yeah, and he's going to have to wait for a faceoff now because he didn't know where that puck was.
Fourth shot in 5 power plays. Paul Brinkman had 2 goals for the Toros tonight near 2-1 win over the Sharks. Artie Riekke just handed me the game sheet. I was looking for the Canadiens, and appears that it was John Davey who got them going tonight in the 3-2 win, a goal and an assist. Denton and the Leafs in this one have a 2-1 lead and try to break out with 15 seconds left in the power play. Merrick gives it back to Denton. Denton looks around. 8 seconds left. Gauthier can't hang on to the pass. Leafs snap it down, though, into the Hawks zone. Studley chases it. He's got one of the 2 goals for the Leafs. Studley avoids Kevin Ryan. Studley trying to get it in front. And gets it deflected away with Drew Fitzgerald picks it up. Fitzgerald clears it out. Denton, can he keep it in? Barely keeps it in. Denton did a great job. Now Evans picks it up for the Leafs. 4 minutes to go. And the Leafs on top, 2-1. They're trying to nurse this to the finish line. As it is cleared down, Marr picks it up. Blackhawks start back. Mulkern. Pat Mulkern for Bruce Humphreys. A lazy pass that Denton knocked down. Mulkern picks it up. As now the Hawks try to start again. Fitzgerald had a couple of good maneuvers in the second period. One on a power play, but Andy Pelley was up to the task. Mike Ryan clears it out for Jack Carrig. Jack Carrig rolls the long shot to the far corner. Picked up by Dave Salvaggio. Salvaggio now trying to get it. Carrig as it comes free. Now, if when Rick Kelly shows up for a Chick Hydro post game, we've got to see if he is doing it. As it's squeezed towards the front by Dunn, broken up. We still have plenty of time. We still can't figure out who's going to be player the game in this one. Lions, Salvaggio. And the 37th, yeah, Lions. Yeah, yeah, Paul Lions, 37th penalty of the year on the Hawks. Their 7th penalty of the night.
Wow.
7 penalties for the Blackhawks. Lions for a high stick. Paul Lyons shakes his head and says, well, wait a minute. .246 left, and boy, the Leafs, they don't care about goals in this one, more as time, but they would love to get the goal because it would give them the 2-goal advantage. But, I mean, they could just kill off more time. But the Blackhawks.
That's what, five penalties this period? Yeah, that's crazy.
It's crazy. It is. All of a sudden, the Blackhawks have become just coming apart, and Denton rolls one in. Fifth shot, and this is penalty, power play 6 overall. Dunn trying to get ahead, cut off by Harrington. And the crazy penalties because they're away from the play and you know, don't need to. A couple of them, you know, one with Tony Roeder,
yeah,
I understood.
Behind the play. Yeah. This wasn't a smart penalty at all.
Harrington, nice shot, saved by Triani. But, yeah, I mean, the one with Tony Roeder, I understood with Paul Mayer. And even, you know, it
right.
was one of those. It was, you know.
And then just the Mayer got away with something, that's yeah. all. And even Mayer even knew it, so.
Yeah, that happens. 43 seconds left as it's cleared down the other end. Mosca and the Blackhawks like to get something here in this shorthanded situation. They got to start getting something to the goal as it's flipped wide by Parrish off the backboards. They're trailing 2-1. They barely have got a shot on net in this period. 21 seconds left to kill on the Lions penalty because they got to figure out when to pull Vinny Triani. Jack Carrig taps it off. Malloy coming in. Sean Malloy fires it. Save Vinny Triani. And Triani with 8 seconds left on the Leaf power play will see the faceoff as it will be to his left. And now you get to be wondering when the Blackhawks call the timeout
yeah,
and set everything up.
This would be a good time to call it right now.
They will do it right now.
Yep. Got to win this faceoff, get this puck out of the zone, and Vinny follow him.
Because they will also have Paul Lyons.
8 seconds yep. left on the penalty kill.
As we have another night of Billy Sawtelle, we love you type hockey. 4 games complete so far. This is game 5 in the league. 3 of them are 1-goal games. One was a shootout. One was a blowout.
Yeah, the only blowout
was
the Crusaders over the Saints. Yeah.
Yeah. And this is a 1-goal game. Bill Sawtelle, we love you hockey because the player personnel director for this league is sitting there who doesn't like anybody according to him. And this is a big faceoff. Oh, nice maneuver by Polito. That was sweet. He just went right into the faceoff. Polito gets bumped off the play by Parsons. Triani to the bench.
And I think that was a good penalty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jack Parsons.
Parsons is going off. Or somebody is.
Yes, Jack Parsons is going off.
No, I don't think it is. I think it's Malloy.
Sean Malloy's second penalty.
They got some Malloy doing something behind the play.
Hooking.
Okay, and Blackhawks a little can't figure out what to do on this faceoff, yeah?
Timeout now blue,
The Maple Leafs are calling one.
Sean Malloy's second penalty. 6 on 4 in the final 71 seconds. Oh, last time Sean Malloy went off on a penalty. Don Studley was set up very nicely by Jeff Gauthier to tie the game. Jeff Gauthier is back out there at this point. Blackhawks, it's simple for them. They got to crash the net. They're not exactly been wizards with the puck offensively. They've been, you know, let's crash the net and be blue collar. Fallon, Gauthier, faceoff. Gauthier wins it. Maher has it. Tries to clear it out. Nice job. Barcelo with the blue line. In front. Polito. Oh. Block. What a play by Dave Denton.
Yeah.
What a play by Dave Denton. Under a minute to go. Kevin Ryan gets the puck from his knees. Gets it ahead. Oh, Dave Denton. One of the sweetest defensive plays of the season.
I think Polito's still trying to figure out what happened.
Polito couldn't believe it. And Polito comes back with a nifty pass for Norman Rassikot. In front, Gauthier clears it out. Picked up, blue line, kept in. Oh. Shot goes wide by Polito. Polito just couldn't get it. Now cleared up by the Leafs. 27 seconds left. As the Leafs just encouraging everybody to plate the plays in the final seconds. Maher near steal. Maher. And the Blackhawks are going to shoot themselves in the foot. They're not. Wow. The Blackhawks just again this sixth penalty of the period.
Mike Maher smelling blood, knew that net was empty, and so he was just going for broke edge, crossing that blue line.
Whoa, it's on Maher. Check that. I'm sorry.
Oh, boy.
I thought a Blackhawk touched that one up. I apologize.
Yeah, I don't know what they got Maher for.
High stick High on stick. Maher. I'll be totally honest with you. I didn't see Maher with a high stick.
I didn't see a stick leave, you know, get above knee height anyway, I don't think.
For 14.5 seconds left, 6-on-3. Paul Lyons directing traffic off the draw. Lyons gets it, shot deflected. Humphreys trying to get it back out. One more try. Humphreys throws it in front, and a clean away by Paul Maron. Might have just decided this game. Lyons snaps
Lyons
at it.
Lyons is going to get called for
the stick above the boot.
Raising his stick above the boot. Now the faceoff's going to be in his zone.
1.9 seconds left, and the Leafs are going to hang on for a 2-1 win. Leafs hang on, 2-1 win. And the Leafs come up with a huge win as far as this one goes, as the Leafs 2, Blackhawks 1. And the Leafs go over the 500 mark and put themselves in a better spot as far as positioning goes in the Classics. They move in the, they just increased their lead in fourth place to 4 points over the Red Wings. Blackhawks suffer the loss, and now Blackhawks just a point ahead of both the Canadiens and the Bruins. We'll have the Schick Hydro postgame show. It's next. I mean,
he had to be him and Mike Maher, I believe, the defenseman for a reason.
Our official game sheet comes in, and it says the penalties, and they have a space for 9 penalties on the sheet. 8 of them are filled.
Wow. Yeah.
I mean, and it was 4 for the Leafs, but 2 in the last few seconds. But, I mean, holy cow, it's just like the Leafs got to feel good about this one. This might have been their most complete performance.
Yeah, they certainly, like I said, they still are struggling offensively, Mark, but, you know, against a team like the Blackhawks, you kind of have to little expect that. But they had an awful lot of power plays to do nothing with, but certainly it's something for them to build upon for next week and obviously moving on to the postseason run. So,
well, Toro Stingers will be our game next week, and we'll have a very, very interesting game as far as that goes, because the Toros are starting to change things around. Paul Brinkman, 2 goals tonight in their win over the Sharks, and Stingers are playing right now as we speak. But as far as this one goes, the Maple Leafs come from behind, beat the Blackhawks 2-1.